low-budget reviews of Fatal Fury Dulce for the Sega Genesis. This is Ron Moore, along with Archangel Zero and The Unknown.
What's up? Yup, yup.
Yeah, and this game is pretty beast.
I like Fatal Fury 2.
Yeah, and when I was a kid, I didn't really like it that much, but then been playing it or watching it here again recently, and the game's much better than what I remembered.
Yeah, I like the intros to all these Fatal Fury games. They did pretty good animation and detail on it. I like that.
And so we're going to do what we did with Fatal Fury 1 and just watch the CPU fight on hard, because they can make this review epic with because they know all the controls.
You can play with controls.
Oh yeah, look, now you can pick out a Mai, and she introduced the animated boobs animation, which everybody loves to watch.
Not me, yuck. And all right, now we're in Terry Bogard's stage. And what state is that? I forgot what Mount Rushmore is at.
Oh yeah, Mount Rushmore. I think those are like the dead presidents.
No, they're still alive. Shut up. And yeah, this, and the soundtrack in this game is pretty awesome. And yeah, Terry's stage right here is all right. They still do the day to night transitions.
Yeah, I like how they play, you know, pay close attention to the details in this game, especially the backgrounds. Something that Street Fighter never did. I like the detail on this a lot, and they kept the foreground and background switching. I think that transitioned over to this game pretty well too.
Yeah, really. And right now, I feel like I'm playing Turtles in Time.
See, what I like what they did on here, they're like flying on top of a train. You can see like the background looks like it, you know, it looks like the train is moving. And that's something that Capcom really hasn't done in the Street Fighter series, not even till recently, so it's something that they completely left out.
Yeah, and I like how it still, like Unknown said, you can still go in the background, the foreground. I guess you had to do a background check on this game. Fail.
Not a whole lot of background check, but I guess like you guys were saying, I like the day, evening, and night modes for every, you know, more than one fight. You know, every round is different.
Yeah, and Rising Taco, what is he saying? Oh, got her.
He says Rising Taco.
And so. How you saying it? My Shrenyu?
My Shruzula!
Like how they have a female now in Fatal Fury.
Yeah, I like how they did a very good job with the 16 boobs, 16 bit, you know.
What's funny is this is a Japanese company, and even for its time, they went all out, found American landmarks. Knowing that this game is going to be played in the U.S., even though it didn't hit that hard, but I mean, that's pretty cool. It's like they respect the Americans, you know?
I think we respect all countries because, you know, there's a lot of different countries in this game. Unlike the first one, it's just Southtown, Florida, wherever they were at. Now they're like, you can travel all over the world to face opponents, and each stage has cool backgrounds and cool animations and stuff relating to what part of the world they're at, so that's pretty cool. What? You know, I can be Terry in his own stage with a sweep kick. Come on.
Yep, that's a good pose.
She's the winner! Winner!
My fist is a girl. No one can stop it.
Oh man, this Kim right here is notorious, man. In every game he's been, he's probably one of the most played characters and easy to play also.
Yeah, and I like Lawrence Blood. He's pretty cool. Kind of like he's one of the few, I think, bullfighter fighters in video games. Like others are Vega and I think a few others from other games. I don't know.
Yeah, I think Vega from Street Fighter doesn't look too much like a bullfighter. He's more of like a cage fighter. Lawrence is like a piece of the door, which I've to this day never seen a 3D bullfighter in any game. So I think whoever does it again will have a trophy.
Yeah, and well, Vega, not really a bullfighter, but like I forgot Vega's backstory, but I know like he was from Spain and he could be a bullfighter. It'd be interesting to see if they make another Capcom vs. SNK game, Vega versus Lawrence Blood.
Who knows? I mean, you know, it could happen. You never know. I mean, they're looking for other people. I know they got the Street Fighter X Tekken, which was Namco. So they do the SNK again. I hope they do it big, you know, and make a, you know, trilogy of it. Because, I mean, I really enjoyed SNK versus Capcom and SVC Chaos. So to me, they're like two of my favorite games.
Yeah, and Kim is like the master of kicks, right?
Yeah, I think he's like Taekwondo, and that's all they do in Taekwondo is kicks. So my girlfriend told me she's like karate. She's like their worst enemies are Taekwondo. So Taekwondo versus karate is always going to be a good fight.
Yeah, I like the controls.
Oh, what?
You see his move? It's kind of like that Bison move where he comes at you with his stick, tries to stab you like the bull. I think that's cool.
Yeah, and Kim just ripped off Gaul. Look at the flash kicks. Man, come on, ripped him off.
Yeah, the flash kick. I didn't think about that.
Kim goes hard in CVS 2.
He goes hard in every game, really. I mean, if you use Kim, more than likely you're going to win.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I guess getting back to what you guys were saying about the crossovers or doing the SNK Capcom game. I think they did a very good job with the SNK Capcom vs. SNK 2. I think they should build on that and make a part 3. I think the it gives you know a lot of room for you know putting something new out there and I guess creativity too. You know.
Yeah, I think they kind of did with SVC Chaos.
They did. They got really creative with SVC Chaos, but the new genre now is 3D. So, you know, they do a 3D with the Marvel vs. Capcom, 3 engine. I think they could do a really good job.
Oh, I love this water stage. How it's got that whole Wrath of the Titans kind of feel to it, and they're on a looks like a floating boat or some kind of wood.
You say Wrath of the Titans?
Yeah, Wrath of the Titans isn't that the new movie that came out?
Clash of the Titans?
I think that's the old one. That's the first one. I like the little owl in that movie. He's constantly falling down, can't get up.
Yeah, they took the owl out of the new movie, the remake, so... oh, yeah, and by the way, this is my favorite character, Chang, because he moves his hands like he's like some kind of, what do you call it, like snake fighting or some type of kung fu. That's pretty cool. They made a fat dude that can actually know kung fu. I think that's really cool.
Yeah, but he has, like, spirit power or something. He really sucks, but because of his spirit power, he's really good.
Yeah, I think he's like a black belt. I think maybe he was skinny at one time and got really depressed because his wife left him. And then he just went and started eating and got an eating disorder. But look at him. I mean, he beat Mike. I mean, what can you say?
That's because he eats too much.
Yeah, he ate his twin in the womb.
Yeah, Venom said he's kind of like a mixture of Blanca and somebody, I forgot, like, he does a roll attack and stuff, and I just thought, every time he gets hit, you hear him, he goes, ow! Shut up, you sissy. But yeah, I mean, he is a good fighter, though, and this stage and this track right here is pretty awesome.
Yeah, the music's pretty cool. I like how that's always been carrying over, too. You can actually play it and just listen to it, and you won't be bored of it.
Yeah, and Ching or whatever his name is has some weird fruity looking moves.
Well, pain probably hurts him because that's probably why he screams like that. And not only that, it's kung fu. If you ever watch kung fu old fights, it does look kind of weird, you know.
Yeah, I never hear anybody scream like a sissy though, like come on, take the pain like a man. Do what Quan Chi Kane said. You must embrace and become one with the pain.
I think his voice is very unique. It's almost like a scream of a banshee. Maybe he sings opera or something.
Yeah, I think he sings the opera in his shower.
What kind of a taunt was that? Did he fart?
Yeah, he wants you to inhale his essence.
There's a fish movie, you can knock him in the water, right? No.
That would be Eternal Champions.
I never played that game.
That game is epic.
Oh, what?
Chang looks like a lot of people I work with.
Like who?
Well, my supervisor, the guy that sits next to me, the people that do the vending machines, and the security guards.
The vending machine that was made by Venom?
Yep. And he looks like all of those guys.
Yeah, why is it the same pose every single time?
Because they're posers.
Nah, I think they ran out of memory on the cartridge.
Oh, look, they got Jubei. He's always eating some type of rice cakes or something.
Yeah, cookies or something. I don't know. But he kind of reminds me of Tung Fu Roo. Probably because he's old.
Yeah, in a way, except he can't get roid rage, but I heard he's a really good character to use. I think his style is judo, which revolves around grappling in a way, like fast grappling and flipping, sitting just like that.
He just tosses cookies.
Yeah, this is my favorite character in Fatal Fury 2. Venom and I used to go at it with each other on the special. But I like the way he grapples a lot. He's fast. It's kind of like he walks up to you, and then before you know it, he's already grabbing you and flipping you over.
Oh, I think he just missed a flip he was trying to do right there. Oh, wait. Oh!
Oh, that was Zangief's move from Street Fighter.
That's what I was thinking. It's like a ECW version of Zangief spinning palm driver. I don't know.
I like how SNK used almost the same moves, but they gave like all the moves to different people. I like that.
Oh, again. Oh.
Like Kim has Gao's flash kick. What else did I say? The first guy has a... can't remember.
What's that fist move that Terry did called?
The rising tackle?
No, that's that upward kick he does. That right there.
Oh, bare knuckle?
No. Man, Axel's gonna get mad.
Yeah, Terry's always Terry in pretty much every game. He's quite a character. I guess he's probably one of the easiest to use too.
Why does he look like a truck driver all the time?
I think he was probably a truck driver, and then he heard about the tournament and decided to join up because he think he wins some extra money.
Yeah, I guess so. I like the music in the stage.
I do too. I think they got really creative with the music. It makes me want to fight somebody.
Terry just did the Shinobi walk. You see that?
Yeah, it's a Shinobi move.
It's a stage.
It's a stage with color and music, and there's a time limit on it.
Yeah.
I didn't even know he can do that. See? He's like kneeling on the ground, walking. I don't think any game has ever done that.
Shinobi. Oh, I just beat him with Zangief's move. All right, Dr. Wily, you won the match. Calm down. Come back when you're grown up. I know Roy Burson was in this game.
Yeah, he looks a lot like Mr. Miyagi in that pic.
Yeah, really. Come back, you grown up. Hey, Garrett, I want a match. Oh, Terry Bogard again against Axel Hawk. I think he's the student of Michael Max. Is that right?
I believe so. They look alike, actually.
And Terry stage again. Oh, dang. Oh, what? I didn't know Butterbean was in this game. That's pretty cool.
Butterbean.
Dang, the unknown limits of go. Oh, wait. No, it's not.
Yeah, sometimes I do that. But I let my hands go first.
Right. Man, he's murdering Terry. What? Dang, what?
Been playing a lot of Mike Tyson's Punch Out.
Yeah, really. Oh, man, two-pieced him. Knocked his hat off. And then some. Yeah, I think I read somewhere that Michael Max was Axel Hawk's trainer.
Yeah, I know. I think he looks like, what's the name? I can't remember his name.
Yeah, that guy?
Huh?
Man, Axel Hawk got them hands, Cuddy.
Oh, yeah, I was going to say he's got some big underwear.
Yeah, really.
I start wearing my underwear like that.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah, I think he wears those gloves everywhere he goes, so like if he needs to grab a handle, he just knocks it down instead.
Yeah.
Damn, you see those back muscles he got?
Yeah, really. Oh, the clock's ticking, dude. Now Terry's giving him a fight. Oh. Oh, bust you. What did he say? Bust you up or mess you up?
I think he said, I'll mess you up.
Ah, oh, he won by time limit. Dang, George Foreman whooped Terry Bogard.
It's just show him cooking on his grill up there.
Yeah, really, knocking out people's grills. All right, we got Maya against Terry again in the same stage. Man, he's got, how many times is he going to lose in the stage?
I don't know, man, but they need to change the stage.
I know, right?
Yeah, because those presidents are dead already.
Well, whoever in CPU mode, I don't know about two-player mode, but in the CPU versus CPU, the player one is it goes to their stage by default for some reason instead of picking stages at random. I kind of think it's dumb, but oh well.
Yeah, I think that does work. Somebody call the Amber Lamps.
Yeah. Now the Epic Beard guy's not on this one. He was on the first one.
What's up?
I think they got Big Bear again, but in his naked mode.
His face is naked.
I want to see him not naked mode, but you know where he's wearing the big underwear.
Nah, you don't see him naked. Oh, time up.
My. Yep, that's what I wanted.
Man, Terry lost again by a time expiration date. Yeah, that's lame.
I think he wants to lose because he wants to see Mai's pose at the end.
Yeah, really.
If you're a fighter, would you beat a girl up? I think Terry can't defeat girls.
He's a gentleman and a ladies' man.
I think he's too blinded by her chest.
Yeah, mine's got those chesticles.
Oh, got her with the rising taco. Who would have went out, Chun-Li and Mai?
I think they will knock each other out.
Someone made a video where they did some animation and had Mai win.
That'd be a tough one to win, man. I mean, I don't know. I think I have to agree with them knocking each other out, too.
I think Chun-Li will win. But, well, Terry won, finally. He won a round, but it's not over yet. Can he redeem himself at his own stage in round three?
I wonder which fighters are going to be next.
Probably Terry Bogard and my... No. Terry Bogard versus Terry Bogard in USA 1. So, is he better on here or CBS 2?
I don't know which moves they added or took out for Fatal Fury 2, so I don't know how much better he is.
Oh, what?
I like the controls.
Oh, he got her! Man!
He got her pregnant?
Terry redeemed himself at his own stage. You were good. You fought well. Man, nice saying there. Nice victory commentary. That sounds like something Andy would say, not Terry. Oh, Billy Kane versus Big Van Vader. I mean, Big Bear.
This is a match I want to see. Big Bear and Billy fight. Two new characters on this game.
It's like I said, man. Look at the details on this background, man. There's animation going on. The colors are all flowing together. Look at the shadowing in the back, man. This is like I said, man. It's no other game, any other fighter for that matter. I think did very good detail and animation like this at the time.
Yeah, and the background interacts with the fight because you can knock him in the background. At some stages, you can. Jump in the background, you know, and fight, but on here you can't because you get hit by those gears, and you can knock your opponent into the gears and your opponent would take damage.
What game is that?
This game.
That you can knock them into the gears?
Yeah.
Who told you that?
I've seen it.
Which video?
Maybe this one. I don't know. I've seen it done on here. But Big Bear, formerly known as Raiden from the first Fear of Fury, took off his mask and became a face wrestler, and but this character is inspired by the real life former wrestler Big Van Vader.
Yeah, Big Bear's a pretty cool looking character, man. They even left in his bald spot in there. I like how they did that.
Yeah, now he has a more improved spray from his mouth. Instead of the mist, is like a fire now.
Oh yeah, and. I think they were going to make him look like Ric Flair, but,
what? You mean Andy Bogard?
He's going to say, like, woohoo! How does Ric Flair do it?
Woo! You shop, kid!
Yeah, they're going to make him look like that, but they didn't want to get sued.
Billy Kane looks like a European gangster. I don't know.
He does, in a way, though. He's good with the nightstick.
And now he was supposed to be... He is in the first Fear of Fury, but not in the Sega Genesis version. They took him out. He's like Geese's right-hand man. Is that right?
Yeah, he's like his bodyguard, I think.
Oh, beat him with a dropkick.
Yeah, he does more of those wrestling moves, man. Yeah, I like how Billy Kane uses his stick to beat everybody up. He's a cheater, and I think, hey, if you're going to win, you're going
to win. Yeah, this should have Big Bear use a chair. Very cool.
That's kind of cool. He uses a pinata stick to defeat people.
Yeah. Oh, Terry in his own stage again versus Wolfgang Krauser. Man.
Yeah, this guy's like crazy, man. He's got moves all over the place. He's strong. Like the ultimate wrestler fighter around.
He's even wearing a championship belt. And he has Iron Man pants and boots. That's awesome. And so he's like the half brother of Geese Howard, is that right?
Of Geese Howard, yeah. Yeah, I think he hates Geese, like he tries to kill him all the time, but yeah. Well, Wolfgang Krauser is like one of my favorite characters. Like him and Chang are my favorite characters in this game.
Oh, he tried to do the super Sonic Boom or whatever it was, but Terry countered it. And from what I understand, Krauser is the only man that Geese Howard has ever feared. Look, he just wipes his hands like, oh, I'm done. That was easy.
Pretty much. In the series, I don't think Terry can beat him. He has to team up with, I think, Andy Bogart to defeat him.
I heard that Terry did beat him in the rematch, and then Krauser got so depressed from that he killed himself.
Well, yeah, after he got defeated by Terry, but actually Terry got depressed because he got defeated by Krauser, and then he was practicing with Andy, who won the series or whatever, like in the anime. And then once they defeated him, Krauser committed suicide. He jumped off his little cliff castle where he lived at and just fell into the water. But I don't know if he died. I don't think he died.
Explain that again.
Basically, no.
I think he survives because like his body doesn't float up, and then the anime cuts off to I think that point, so it leaves a lot to to think about.
Krauser's a beast.
He's very beastly.
And I'm look out. Oh, Terry's still alive. Oh, 2 seconds. Wait a minute. Oh, Terry won that one barely. Ugh. Where's that? Yeah, that's got to be heartbreaking for Krauser. They should put Krauser in CBS2 and him and Rugal would have had an ultimate fight.
I would pay to watch that.
Yeah, it should be CBS3, but I don't think it'll happen because Capcom's not cool anymore.
Well, they cut a lot of companies cut their losses, so if they don't think they can make money, I don't think they're gonna do it.
Man, they would make money. Put this on PS3, CBS3. Man.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. I mean, think about it. Nowadays, they could do it as a downloadable game and save money on shipping and everything like that. All they have to do is just make the game and then bust out with some extra features that you can get, like color, different outfits, or I don't know, add something to the game.
Yeah, I would download it.
I would give Krauser like different type of wrestler suits, like a Hulk Hogan suit and what's that dude with the pink underwear? I forgot his name.
Rick Martel?
No, he had the sunshades on. I think he died or his brother died. Somebody.
I don't know. But anyway, Terry is finally outside of the stage and in Chin stage. Chin stage is pretty cool. I like the music too.
Yeah, this is an epic battle for me. I think Chin will actually win.
I'd give it to... I don't know, man. I think they're going to knock each other out.
I think Terry will win. Dang, his shirt. Man, he's busted through his shirt. That's how fat he is.
I think Chan got a lot of style.
He's got a lot of food in him. I'll give him that. Oh, look, is that Bruce Lee's dragon back there?
Yeah, that was the dragon they worshipped to be a better fighter.
That's a dragon scroll from a... Raging Panda, whatever. What was it called?
Kung Fu Panda.
Yeah. Dang, he's doing the bonker roll, and he farted on him. How'd those suspenders fit him, man? Fat, man.
That's the only thing holding his gut up, though.
Yeah. Time up. And, Chin Lee won. Like, he gets tired easily. He wipes himself. Watch his face. Oh, I'm tired. Ugh.
That's Beast.
Nah, Beast is an X-Men.
Nah, I'm going to start moving my hands like Chang.
Nah, you'll get jumped.
I get jumped by other people that look like Chang.
You should walk down the street of East Waco doing that with the Jerry curls and see how long you live.
Not very long.
Oh!
Yeah, I think you should make a documentary on on Chang's life story or something, walking down the street.
Yeah, really. But he's filthy rich, though.
I think so. That's why he's that big, because he's too rich.
I want to eat in that restaurant, Sea Palace.
That's Chang's restaurant.
Yeah. More than any busters.
Yeah, they need people to eat food there.
Dang, they're fighting through the wee hours in the morning.
Because Chegney, he's got a lot of energy.
Not spirit power.
He's got those spirit fingers.
Yeah. Oh.
He should be a Dallas Cowboy cheerleader.
I like how when he falls down, he doesn't even try to get back up. He just kicks you.
Yeah, really? He tries to break dance. Imagine a guy that fat break dancing.
I've seen it before, actually, and it was kind of cool to see him do a lot of backspins. Yahoo! All he wants is Terry Bogard to work for him. That's why they're fighting.
Yeah.
Man, I wonder what kind of food they have in there. I'm getting kind of hungry.
Japanese seafood.
I think they got Oriental food.
Oh, man. That was down to the wire.
That's how he wins all his matches, down to the wire. And look at him. He has to wipe off all his man sweat.
Barely won. See, look. I must rest and recover my spirit power. Shut up.
That just means he needs to eat a lot of food.
Yeah.
Let's see who's next, man. I'm time for some new characters. Oh, okay. So he's gonna manhandle her.
Yeah, this is gonna be epic.
Yeah, it's gonna be a lot of grabbing.
Yeah.
She's like, "You ain't gonna grab me, Krauser." He goes, "Shut up, I chunk a fool."
Yeah, it's like, "Get back in that kitchen."
They make me a sandwich.
Yeah, I did it again. I said, "Get in the kitchen."
Give me some Kool-Aid.
Oh, yeah. He beats her so bad that water turns to blood. That'd be brutal.
And he goes, and get naked. Get naked. That's how a Krauser sounds.
Yeah, really. I said, "Ooh, look!" He throws it. I said, "Get in the kitchen."
I'll slap you in my belt.
He he hovers over her when she's asleep.
Yeah.
He watches her all night.
Yeah. It's creepy.
Man, Krauser's a beast.
Yeah, he is.
He's like jumping around like Spider-Man, cause.
Yeah. Oh, he's telling her to get in the kitchen. She won't stay.
Put a lot of mayonnaise on my sandwich.
Hey, yeah. And Krauser has service in his castle, so he, you know, he's not used to a woman fighting back, saying, "No, I won't make you a sandwich."
Yeah, and then she hits him with her fan, and he's like, "What?
Yeah. Oh, the kitchen move again. Again. He's hungry, man. He wants something in the kitchen. See?
look at that hand in the back, man. What's he grabbing?
Something.
I think they're all trying to grab on my.
Look at that. You'll never defeat Krauser with your power. He just stands there looking like a beast.
I like how they all slant their head like their heads are too heavy for their neck.
Yeah. Oh. Mai versus unknown Higashi.
Yeah, I'm not. I can't fight. I like the stage. The music's pretty cool on this one.
Yeah, the stage and background, the moonlight on the water, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, look at they put that village on top of the water. I think that's really cool.
Yeah, really.
Look at they got all the villagers clapping and making it rain.
And Joe's much better on this one.
Yeah, I think he's faster. His moves, they polished him up. So I don't think Mai's, I don't think Mai can win if Joe lets down.
So where's Balrog and Sagat? This is Thailand, right?
At this point, they're over, I don't know, some sumo wrestling competition.
Yeah, Thailand, what was it, Sagat and Adon, I think it was.
Yeah, and Bissin.
And Bissin, yeah.
Oh, man, this is down to the wire. Look at the time. Oh, she got him. Man, 2 seconds left.
He kept staring at her chesticles.
Yeah.
Yeah, I haven't seen Joe fight on this one yet, so he's doing pretty good, but I think he still gets distracted.
Yeah, really. And you know what's distracting him? Those villagers making corn.
Yeah, they're making it rain. They're like, ah, la 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 la.
Yeah. Or if you accidentally, you jump in the background, you hit by accident, they'll get up and beat the crap out of you.
Yeah, they'll steal all your money.
Yeah.
Yeah, they got a whole bunch of midgets back there somewhere.
Yeah.
They all know kung fu.
The legend continues.
Those midgets are playing patty cake in the background.
Yeah. Joe makes Sagat's tiger knee look weak. Oh, look at that. Oh. Man.
Oh, that she bypassed a tornado.
Man, nobody could do that. Man, how'd she do that? What? Uh-oh, down to the wire again. She got him again at the end. Man.
She kicked him in the jimmy.
She proved you wrong. She did beat Joe.
Distraction.
Yeah, I think she kicked him in the shins where his balls are at.
All right, Big Bear versus Andy Bogart in Australia.
It's going to be a good fight. The little brother gets to fight the big bear.
Yeah. Oh, oh. So this is the modified version of Raiden's music from the first Fatal Fury.
What's he biting at?
Headbutting him. What? Dang. he killed Andy.
He's doing all those prison moves.
Big Bear's a beast.
Well, they are in Australia, I think. It used to be a place for like exiled prisoners a long time ago.
They eat kangaroos raw.
Yeah. Oh, what?
Choking nigger.
Oh, he went through that fireball. What? There's sheep in the background. Well, I know there's sheep in Australia.
They use them for their fur.
Uh oh, Andy now ticked off.
Andy's coming, he's on that roid rage.
Yeah, really. Oh, he got him.
I like how they changed the fire breath to fire.
Yeah. Dang, what? It is never nighttime in Australia.
I know, right? I don't think Big Bear can see. He's got astigmatism.
I like the bear, though, with his mask on. I like how in CBS 2, they put the mask back on, but he still has the beard.
Yeah, the small little details that they do in some games are pretty cool.
Dang, he's got a lot of big old fireball out of his mouth now. Look at that.
Yeah, really.
That, he's been eating a lot of those hot Cheetos.
Yeah.
Man, who's gonna win?
Oh, Sandy.
Yeah, that's pretty cool, man. I like how SNK did every character. It gave its like their own wardrobe, you know. So I don't think I've seen that in other games.
I like it when they share the same wardrobe, like Ken and Ryu.
Yeah. Oh, Andy versus Jube in Italy.
Italy. Oh, wait, we haven't seen this stage before.
Yeah, it's pretty cool stage of music.
Yeah, look at the barrels of beer.
Yeah, the stage is barrels of fun.
It's like a before and after picture of Andy, him and the old guy.
Yeah. Are they supposed to have Donkey Kong in the background throw barrels at you?
Dang, he went off on that old guy. He's like, I'm never gonna look like you, old guy.
No, don't do that. Don't do that. He's old.
He drop kicked him in the face. Ah, he's tearing up his shins.
Dang, sweet shin music. Oh, Zangief power driver. Dang, Jubei does the Shinobi Walk too. I wonder if all of them do.
Uh-oh. Let's see if Jubei's gonna throw a block of cheese at him and win like that.
Yeah. Throw those rice cakes at him. You can't have your rice cake and eat it too. Oh, this is close. Oh, Andy barely won.
Almost looks like a real ninja fight because they're moving like pretty stylish.
Yeah, really. They should have a ninja in this game. That'd be pretty cool.
Actually, Andy's kind of dressed like a ninja, actually.
I like the boots, man. They got that kind of flare going on.
Ric Flair?
Yeah.
You got those military boots, what they call it, combat boots?
Yeah. They got the Leaning Tower of Pisa from Castlevania Bloodlines in the background.
Oh, yeah, I think I see Belmont in the back.
Yeah.
I like pizza.
Pizza was originated in Italy, right? And then went to New York?
Yeah, I believe so.
In New York, they got those big slices of pizza, the ones that can cover up your whole face.
Yeah. Oh, got him. Jubei with his hand over his face to the ground. Oh, lost.
They're gonna have to buy the old guy a casket.
Yeah, really. Oh, it's Andy versus Mai now. From what I understand, do they like each other, or Mai has a crush on him, or what?
I think Mai likes Andy, but I think Andy doesn't want to do anything with Mai because he'll probably lose his manhood to Mai, so he plays hard to get.
Yeah, he's like he doesn't put out until he gets his food first.
What? His soul food?
Yeah, his organic soul food.
I think he's just scared because what if he gets her pregnant and he won't be able to fight in the tournament?
Yeah. It was Mai's grandfather that trained Andy, right?
Yeah, the old guy, I think Jubei.
No, Jubei was the enemy of Mai's grandfather.
Oh, something like that. I just know they're all old.
Yeah. That's a good fight here between the couple. I mean, Andy and Mai. Oh, this is what domestic violence would be like in their house if they were married.
Pretty much. It would be like, give me child support. I said no.
Uh-oh. Time up. Man, who won that one? I think Mai did. Barely. Yeah.
She got the child support.
Yeah.
Awesome, man. Fight!
Mortal Kombat!
Oh, man. This is Streets of Rage Stage 4 right here, is it?
5? Pretty much, it looks like the remake.
Yeah. What's that move call that Andy does with his arms right there?
He says something like, I'll get him or something.
Oh. Seems like Mai always win the close calls. Will she win again?
I'm going to give it to Mai.
I'll give it to Mai because she always wins, except for this one.
Man, y'all both lost. Italy at night.
Dang, it's dark out there. They have no street lights.
Except the boat.
I think they're fighting over whose hair is longer.
I like to flirt with each other. You see that? They're both taunting. He's fixing his hair. And she's having hot flashes. Look at the tower in the back. Now it looks like Castlevania Bloodlines.
Oh, yeah. I didn't notice that till now. It's pretty cool.
I think there's Dracula floating in the background.
Yeah. He's a hidden character in the game. Him and Krauser fight.
I would actually pay to watch that.
Oh. That's another good fight. Oh, but she got him.
Love that pose.
Oh, is that the best you can do? That's no way to talk to your boyfriend or your love interest, man. I mean, what would she do to someone that she hates?
She's mad because he won't put out.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, man, it's ought to be good. I believe I will win this one.
Yes, Lawrence Blood. This guy's pretty awesome, and his stage. Where you can also use the background to your advantage. You can knock them into the bulls, and the bulls knock you back into the foreground. It's pretty cool, and I love the music in the stage, too.
Like, no way, dude. The bulls can, like, hit you.
Yeah, really. Oh.
Man, look at these bulls. Makes me want to eat a steak.
Yeah. What a bunch of bull. Oh, man. And just carving him up with that knife or sword or whatever it is.
This is a steak knife.
Look at that, man.
You see that sign in the background that says tortillas or something?
Yeah, it does. Tortillas? Something like that.
I think it says tortas.
Yeah. Man, he is just killing Joe. Oh, wait a minute. Joe might have had enough. Oh. Man, one thing is kind of makes sense. I know it's just a video game, but how are the bulls going to run around you and not toward you?
I think they're all tied to like a chain.
Oh, yeah. That'd be an intimidating fighting stage, though. All these bulls running around you. I would be distracted.
I think it smells like bull crap in the back, so they can't concentrate.
This is a bunch of BS. Stage is full of BS. Man, he murdered Joe.
While he's fighting, he's stepping on bullcrap everywhere.
Yeah, really.
He's like, ooh.
Oh, Butterbean again versus Terry Bogard.
I'll give it to Butterbean.
They're in Butterbean's stage now.
Yeah, I think. Oh, look. Yeah, this is where if you touch the ropes, like, you get electrocuted.
Yeah. Because you can use that to your advantage, too, in the background. Are they at New York?
I think they're fighting on a rooftop somewhere.
Yeah, they might be. That's like an Israel stage or something. And, yeah, this is a cool wrestling ring or boxing ring here.
I don't think it's on a rooftop anymore because those are cars in the background, right?
Yeah, unless they somehow got the big rig up there on the roof.
I don't think so.
Big Bear could.
Yeah, Big Bear could carry it on his back.
Yeah. He's got him on the ropes, but he's not being electrocuted somehow.
He's spamming that rising tackle. That's what I would do.
Yeah, right. Man. How's it feel? Get beaten your own stage.
Okay. I think in the anime, Terry Bogard, I think he had a wife or a girlfriend and she died. So he becomes like the lonely wolf because like he's like depressed or whatever.
Terry depressed? When I look at him, he seems like a party dude. When Andy's like the quiet dude.
That's on the outside, and the inside, he's dying. It's like that song goes, I'm dying inside. Tell me why. Why must I cry? Why must I cry? Why? Then you see me like singing in the shower naked.
Oh man.
Tell me why. For those of you who've seen Ray Dog's video, Why Must I Cry? You should get a good laugh out of it.
Yeah.
Yeah, dang, he got him with the burnt sausage or something. I don't know.
He knocked his mouthpiece out, too. Man, now he beat him and his on stage. Man, come on, say something more creative. You were good. You fought well. With his head slanted because it's too heavy for his neck.
That looks like a jail picture.
Yeah. All right, who's next? NG Bay stage.
Man, two old guys.
I don't know if Krauser's old, but maybe he's like mid-40s or something.
I think he's going through a midlife crisis.
Yeah, really. NG Bay stage is all right. Music's kind of cool, too. I like Japanese music better.
I think this one's a little bit better. I don't know. I like it. I like because, the pictures they have in the bag, you can break them and stuff.
Yeah, you can fight behind those things too, and you can't see until you knock them out of the way.
I think that's Kuma statue in the background from Street Fighter.
Yeah. Capcom gave him permission back then to use that.
Well, he is a god or something like that.
Yeah, like Thor.
Yeah. Dang! He dodged that Sonic Boom.
The rice cake. Oh, wait. Yeah, that's right. Oh, look. Oh, man.
Man, I wish I could do a move like that in an alley somewhere.
Yeah, man, really.
I'll get a whole bunch of stray cats and put them in like a little dumpster or something and then just Sonic Boom them.
Yeah. Dang, he beat crap. How are you going to beat somebody with Iron Man pants?
Because it don't cover up his whole body.
Oh, yeah. Only his legs are Iron Man-ish.
But if you get hit by his legs, I feel sorry for you.
Yeah, really.
I wonder who actually cleans his house. He's got like a lot of room to get lost.
He used to be a hoarder, but somebody caught the cops on him.
Yeah, a hoarder. Oh, man, he just keeps countering the supersonic boom. Oh, man, see, come on. Oh, man, he is just whooping up on Krauser. Who does that? Oh, look. Oh, wrong time to eat a rice cake.
Get him. He's dead.
No, he's still alive. What?
Throw a rice cake. He just started eating them.
Oh.
Jubei is just way too strong for Krauser.
Yeah, that sucks. I wanted Krauser to win.
I like Jubei. He's pretty cool. Come on. This is going to be an epic fight right here.
Yeah, really.
I like Big Bear, but I go for Krauser this time.
Yeah, me too.
So they're both wrestlers, so there should be a lot of grabbing.
Yeah, really. Krauser's a wrestler?
I think he is. That's that belt. He's like a professional wrestler.
Yeah. Looks like a mix between Kevin Nash and I guess the Ultimate Warrior.
Wasn't Kevin Nash called like Razor Ramon or something like that?
No, that was Scott Hall. Kevin Nash was Diesel.
Oh, okay. He reminds me of Razor Ramon.
So we got Vader versus Razor Ramon here. Yeah, that reminds me of Saturday Night Slam Masters.
Oh, yeah, I remember that game. I like it.
What game is that?
Friday morning pile drivers.
I just recently got a new PS3 game that the Luchador game, I think it's called, like AAA or something like that, Lucha Libre.
Oh yeah. What does AAA stand for? American Auto Parts Applications, because you know they gotta have a visa to compete in the United States.
They're actually all Mexican luchadors, so I don't know. I think it's fun. So if you like wrestling, I think you should play it.
Do they have El Stingray from Saturday Night Slam Masters in it?
Somebody looks just like him though.
Rey Mysterio.
Yep.
Or Sin Cara, whatever his name is.
Yeah, they have that, what do you call it? That El Fantasma. All these Mexican guys.
El Chico.
They got the taco, the burrito.
Nacho Libre.
Yeah. Oh, man. Krauser just made short work of Bear. Look at that, man. When they tilt their head with that shoulder pad, gold shoulder pad, they're not to be messed with. All right, who's next? Nuh-uh, what?
Oh, my God.
So I'm wondering who's going to win this one.
I give it to Bear.
I give it to the one that has a bigger underwear.
I'm going to give it to, not Bear, but Bear.
You mean Bear 13?
Yeah. Now, bear in mind that these two are Bear.
They're barely clothes on.
Yeah. So, with this match is a metaphor, because Bear has been fighting with himself and struggling with himself and humping himself. What the heck is he doing?
That's some bear hugging.
This is his rape move.
He's a lot better than Bear Hugger from Super Punch-Out.
I think he's, that guy barely lost.
Barely lost, yeah. So who's the bigger bear?
The bald guy.
I think he's like a big Care Bear.
Yeah, how about Big Bear versus Teddy Bear? No. They had to change the name because they didn't want to suit himself.
Look at me, Mom, look at me.
Oh, what? I think humming each other for, man.
I think they're desperate. That's that prison love.
That grab you from behind love.
There's a lot of love in this fight.
Yeah. What?
They eat too many hot Cheetos. I think he's spitting on him.
Oh.
I think a dark bear won.
It's gross.
SNK is awesome for doing this.
Yeah, now they're talking trash to each other.
Like, get over here. Let me squeeze you. He said, give me some chong chong.
Oh, he tapped out. It's over, man. Calm down.
ECW.
You chose the wrong person to challenge.
Dang, look at the way they made him look. They put a lot of detail on him right there.
Yeah, really. Now for the final showdown. Survival mode. 5-on-5. It's pretty epic.
Like, no way, dude.
Krauser, yes! Come on, Chang! My, okay, Krauser. Chang! Somebody pick Chang!
Krauser three or four times, man.
Man, I'm going to give it to Krauser on this one.
And they're at his stage, too, man. The final showdown in Krauser's castle.
Man, he's hosting the tournament, so, yeah, I think he should win.
Yeah, really. I mean, this guy is a beast. I mean, look at that. How many fighters have their own orchestra in the background?
Yeah, I think he's an opera singer in his spare time.
Yeah, really. Toughest opera singer ever.
He probably, tells them, sing and then put me to sleep.
Look, he's a maestro. He's conducting. His fighting conducts the orchestra back there. Look at that, man.
Lawrence Fishburne, I think, is winning.
Now, I love the music on the stage. It's Castlevania-like feel.
Yeah, I agree. I just like the way the castle looks. Like, it makes me want one.
Yeah, really. I want to have. That costs a lot of money to make.
Make one at a trash can.
Yeah. Oh.
This is my tournament, Cuddy.
Yeah.
Hey, why make one out of trash cans when you can live there?
Yeah, really. Oh, look, he's gonna fight himself. Oh, man.
Man, they're gonna sonic boom each other in the beginning.
Yeah, really. But now it's time himself to get in the kitchen.
Make me a sandwich. No, you make me a sandwich.
Ooh, that was epic right there.
Yeah, they're like high-fiving with their foot.
Yeah, really. But one of them couldn't take it.
Ooh.
Uh-oh, Andy.
See who has the longer hair now.
Andy. Thank
you. I think Andy grooms himself more than Krauser does.
Yeah.
He's got one of those dog brushes.
I like how lightning and thunder's in the background. That's epic.
Yeah, it's a lightning.
You gotta ride the lightning.
It's really like one of those strobe lights or something.
Spur up. Ride the lightning, super up.
Oh, my ribs.
My neck, and my back.
Oh, my legs.
Look at me, Mom. Look at me. Oh, I died.
Oh, that was a close one right there, man.
Andy's like, what? I didn't do that. Did I do that?
Oh, the fighting again. The rematch for child support.
Yeah.
He flat out refuses to pay.
Yeah.
He goes, I'd rather go to jail.
Oh, he's got to pay it though again.
Yeah, because they're gonna lock him up. When he gets up, he's in jail.
Yeah. Uh-oh.
Oh, man. He's going to mandler and slap her and then tell her to make a sandwich.
Yeah, he's gonna throw in that direction. Say the kitchen's over there.
It's all over a sandwich with extra mayonnaise.
Yeah, really. I'm sure he's got a big kitchen too. So he's probably got a lot of women back there.
He wants the whole Miracle Whip where he dunks the sandwich in the Miracle Whip.
Yeah, and DiGiorno or mustard or Dijon, whatever it's called.
Honey Dijon mustard or something like that.
Yeah, DiGiorno. Yeah, it's not delivery.
Yeah, I like pizza.
Not pizza patron.
Oh, that's brand is called. Do you have any Grey Poupon?
Yeah, what pizza patron are you talking about?
Oh, see, he's trying to throw her in the kitchen. She won't go, man.
Man, I tell you, the women nowadays do not want to make a sandwich for their man.
Oh, she's going to have to now. She thinks because she's got that child support that she's invincible.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think she's gonna bust out with some new moves.
Uh-oh, bear. Oh, man. This might be over quick. Look at that.
he's been manhandled to death.
Yeah. Look at that. He's bigger than the whole orchestra together, combined back there.
He's the whole turkey, like, raw.
Yeah, really. Dang. Oh, bear versus bear again.
Oh, man, I think Bear's gonna rape him.
Violate himself.
Oh, that was a spirit tackle.
Oh, nice counter. Oh!
That was a Baylor tackle.
Yeah.
He's a Baylor Bear.
Yeah. Oh, Krauser again. He would not die in his own castle.
Nah, he better not die. Or maybe he will die.
Oh, man. That was like, what, a 4-8 combo?
Ooh, Big Bear's gonna have to... Big Bear's gonna have to make him a sandwich.
Yeah, really. And Bear don't like to make sandwiches. He likes to eat them. Oh.
He drinks gravy.
Yeah, he's got a knuckle sandwich.
He's got something in his hand.
Oh, here's the final battle. Billy Kane versus Krauser.
I don't know who's gonna win.
It's gonna be a good one. Damn, he wants everybody to go in the kitchen.
This should be a rap song. We need to play a rap song at the end about being in the kitchen making a sandwich.
Yeah. Oh. What kind of a staff is that? Like a bow staff that has short length chain that make it stretch out?
I think it's a nunchuck sword.
Yeah, I was thinking nunchuck staff. Donatello and Michelangelo's weapon together.
You're a sword.
Yeah. Oh, man, he's in trouble. Oh, he got him. What? He beat Krauser.
He goes, power staff, staff, staff.
And he barely beat Krauser. But either way, Krauser wins because he's a team captain. Yeah, that was a good survival match. Very epic. ECW. So, yeah, man, Fatal Fury 2 for the Sega Genesis. Pretty good game. A lot better than what I thought it was years ago. Probably because I just expected too much of it because I loved the first Fatal Fury for the Sega Genesis. But looking back now and seeing Part 2 again, it's pretty epic. And I like how you can play as the bosses on here. I think you actually had to put a code in to do that. But when I downloaded the ROM, the bosses are already made available. So that was pretty cool. And, yeah, so this game is real fun to play, and it really, even though I liked Fatal Fury 1 better, but now I like Fatal Fury 2 better after giving it another chance and seeing it again after all these years, because I think last time I played it, man, was probably 94 before this review, so it was a long time ago, almost 20 years, and this game is real fun, and it's really fun to watch, so you can see the awesome, epic CPU battles. The background stage environments, how they can interact with the fight, and the music, and just the animations in the background, and all the new characters they got, especially in the bosses, especially Krauser. This game is pretty epic, and yeah, it's ECW. I give it a 8.5 out of 10.
Yeah, I was kind of thinking the same thing, like Ron. I really did like the stages that are moving, that are animated, which a lot of games are not doing these days. They still kept that, I guess, in the old 2D games. And Part 1, I like Duck King, who's my favorite character. Part 2, I like Chang. I like Krauser as a boss better than Geese for some reason. That's just my preference. I like the transition from Big Bear and the old one to this one where he looks more like a wrestler. And overall, I'm not too sure about the moves, which moves are taken out or made stronger, but overall, it looks like a good game. So Ron gave it 8.5. I think I'll give it 8.5. It feels like not a 9 just yet, but yeah, it's getting there.
I guess on everything you guys said, pretty much. As far as this game, being I think this game is not just an improvement over the first one. I think this game actually stands on its own. And there's a lot of things in there that were pretty neat. I guess if you didn't play the first one and you played the second one, I think it's its own game. So I'm gonna give this game for the Genesis version, I'm gonna give this a 10 because it's that good.
Alright, so that is it for low budget reviews of Fatality Fury 2 Fail for the Sega Genesis. I'm Ron Moore.
Archangel Zero.
This is The Unknown.
God bless and take care.
Jerry Curl.